I've been retired a few years. I've always been somebody that likes to do a lot of things. I've been a beekeeper, I've been a mandolin player, but the list is endless. My wife sadly died 1st of February last year. That still feels like it was yesterday. Anyway, you get on and you do things and you need to keep in touch with people. I first got involved in the U3A when my friend across the road said, shall we go down there and see what it's like? Very friendly when we got there. They have small groups that deal with almost anything anybody could be interested in. The poetry group was already running, but they used to meet in other people's kitchens and things like that. I can't do that anymore. So the poetry group went online, and it's about then when I joined it. And it's proved a godsend. I never thought poetry could be so interesting. Well, I think it's very important that older people get to use computers. Once you break the ice, the possibilities literally are endless. You're sort of a little bit ashamed that you don't know things, and you back off. I learned a lot of my stuff through my grandchildren, and I don't mind asking them questions. But yes, older people don't do a lot of things they might enjoy doing because they're so reticent. My wife and her sister were both nearly deaf. They live 100 miles away, sisters in Nottingham. Didn't talk enough, talked like fury when they did meet. And I introduced my wife, first of all, to the mobile phone and taught her how to do texting. So we had to go to Nottingham and persuade her sister Pam to buy a mobile phone, which she'd never done before, and thought, she's an old person, don't do that kind of thing. She bought a mobile phone, we taught her how to do texting, and the two sisters spoke to each other more over the last couple of years than they had for many, many years before through the medium of texting. My daughter Alison, who has Down syndrome, lives away from me here, and she was 50 in December last year. We couldn't get to the house, you're not allowed in. But what we could do is, as a Zoom meeting, there were about 30 of us, all came together on Zoom on her birthday and sang "Happy Birthday to you, Alison." And I thought that was wonderful. If there's somebody who was backing away from going online, I'd say it's a way of getting in touch with people. And as I've said many times, there's almost nothing you can't find there. My grandchildren know how to use it. Why can't I?